of the Lord just for a moment. This morning's scripture reading is very beautiful because it is about beautiful real marriage, which is Christian marriage in God. Someone joked about marriage. It is told that marriage requires a man to prepare four types of rings. So I'm not so sure whether all the men in our church prepared these rings, but I guess some of us prepared the two rings at least. The first one was the engagement ring, and then the second one was the wedding ring, and then the others were suffer ring and endure ring. Well, actually, I guess that is not true. In many cases, it's true, especially for non-believers and their marriages. But we Christians are different. Our marriages, I am sure that most of us are experiencing different types of rings. Engagement ring, wedding ring, and honoring, caring, sharing, and cheering. So actually, that's the Christian marriages and the rings that we are experiencing in our Christian marriage. It is the wish of young people in school, in college, and university to complete the school and get a decent job. But there is a sense in which we are in school for the rest of our lives because we never stop learning. Especially, it is taught that when you marry, it is just like going back to school again, because one learns to love and to forgive in marriage all the time. People want to go back to this second school because, as our first reading says, it is not good that man should be alone. Genesis chapter 2, verse 18. As the boys admire the girls, and the girls admire the boys, they remind us of the words from elsewhere in the book of Genesis in our Bible. God saw all that he had made, and indeed it was very good. The first chapter of Genesis. When boys look at the girls, they say everything God has made is very good. When the girls look at the boys, they say everything God has made is very good. And so after some time, they get married to enjoy this goodness more fully in God's blessings. That is marriage. People spend a lot of money for weddings, especially Hollywood celebrities spend billions and billions of dollars for just one wedding. Kim Kardashian was an example. She spent several billion dollars for one wedding, but her marriage didn't last long, just a few months, and then divorced, and she's doing again. Even though many people spend a lot of money for wedding, a wedding lasts only for one day. But marriage lasts for the rest of our life. When a couple gets married, it has been said both go back to school again, the second at the school of marriage. They begin to learn again, to learn to love each other in a deeper way. And they learn to serve each other in a deeper way. They join themselves to each other to become one, as our first reading stated, without losing their individuality. Becoming one does not happen overnight on the day of a wedding. It is something that is learned, and that the couple becomes better as they share their married life together. Becoming one means loving each other, sharing their lives with each other, and taking each other into consideration more ways. Becoming one means getting rid of all selfishness because there is no room for selfishness in marriage. If selfishness is not poured out right up the weeds around the church or creeps in later on, it is sure to cause problems all the time. If God blesses the marriage with the children, then the children are taken into consideration in all that the couple do. So for these many reasons, it is told that marriage is a school of love. When two people get married, they bring with them to their marriage normal human weaknesses and discover weaknesses in the other which previously they did not know. This is an opportunity to love each other for Christians. This is an opportunity for being hurt, being disappointed, having argument for non-believers. But this is an opportunity, wonderful opportunity, to love each other, to accept each other, to hear each other, and to forgive each other. There are times when, like at the wedding in Cana, it will seem as if the wine really has run out. Times when they forgive each other and make a fresh start. For this reason, marriage is a school of forgiveness. What I have spoken about up to now, the human aspect of marriage would be true of any couple who live together. But marriage in a holy Christian church is much more beautiful. It is not just being partners, not just fulfilling the natural human desire to share one's life with another, because marriage in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, as we confess in our Nicene Creed, is also a sacrament or a self-sacrament. Like all the other sacraments, marriage unites the couple with Jesus Christ and brings them God's blessings. It is not just the husband and wife united to each other in marriage. It is husband and wife united to each other with Jesus Christ before the altar through the holy matrimony. The couple's promise to each other is until death. To be faithful to each other always, and that is why Jesus Christ rules out divorce in this morning's gospel lesson. He said it was not in God's plan. It was introduced by humans because they lowered their vision of marriage and drifted away from God's plan for marriage. The couple's fidelity to each other symbolizes and reflects the faithfulness of God to us who are His people, the faithfulness of Jesus Christ to the church. God is always faithful to His people, including each of you and me. Christ is always faithful to His church, and the couple's promise to be always faithful to each other until death symbolizes and reflects the love of God for His people and the love of Christ for His church. The question is asked, is there anything more beautiful in life than a boy and a girl clasping clean hands and pure hearts in the path of marriage, as we see on the cover of our bulletin? In this picture, you see a young, beautiful man and woman are holding their hands together for holy matrimony. That's a beautiful, beautiful scene and beautiful love. Can there be anything more beautiful than this young love? The answer is actually yes. Yes, there is a more beautiful love. It is an old man and old woman finishing their life's journey together on that path. Their hands are wrinkled and gnarled, but still clasped. Their faces are wrinkled. Their hairs are white, but still radiant. Their hearts are physically bowed and tired, but still strong with love and devotion for one another. Yes, there is more beautiful thing than young love. It is old love in real marriage, because it is from the standing of devotion and dedication to each other, as the Lord does for us. Therefore, a man shall leave his father and mother and hold fast to his wife, and two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but just one flesh. What therefore God has joined together, let not man separate. Let me conclude with this. When we open up our bulletin on the bottom of the announcement page, we will see what Wayne Mack, who is a famous American minister, said about marriage. Marriage is total commitment and total sharing of the total person with another person until death. Isn't that true? That is a real marriage. That is a real being united in Jesus Christ. And that is the real Christian marriage. And also our relationship is like that with our Lord. Our relationship with the Lord is total commitment and total sharing of the total person and total heart until death and for eternity in his kingdom. Because also our Lord's relationship with each of you and me is total commitment and total sharing and total person and heart until his death on the cross and for eternity in his kingdom. So I hope that you discover our Lord's wonderful and infinite love for each of you through also your marriage, that it enhances and strengthens your marriage and your daily life to life everlasting in his kingdom.